A forensic pathologist mainly does autopsies for the coroner or on behalf of the coroner. There's a whole variety of deaths that's referable under the Coroner's Act. And when these deaths occur, we assist the coroner in determining the cause of death.
In a nutshell, a forensic pathologist is a doctor for deceased people. So if you were ill, you'd go see your general practitioner, they would do some tests and they'd tell you what was wrong with you. I do the same thing, except all of my patients are deceased. I need to get the history from police officers and family members. I then do an examination, which is an autopsy. We have a CT scanner, so we do some medical imaging, and then I will do some tests and I will work out what the cause and manner of death is and write a report.
Forensic pathology is, the reason I chose it was because I truly believe it's a calling. It's such a dynamic, interesting discipline that incorporates knowledge of all the aspects of medicine, and literally you are like a detective trying to work out or put together all the clues that you see to come to an ultimate, the end goal is to find out why a person has passed away or died.
In New South Wales, the Coroner's Act requires from us to determine the cause of death in the least invasive manner. For example, imaging or CT scans on all cases or the majority of cases that's admitted to our facilities. You know, things like skeletal fractures, really extensively visible on CT scans. So that enables us to often, you know, determine cause of death without doing an invasive examination. But then if we look at more invasive types of examinations, it's your autopsy examination, which requires evisceration of certain or all of the major organs for examination. We do ancillary testing that's referred to different types of labs. Forensic pathologists, when we do an invasive examination, would take small tissue samples and do histology on those samples.
We might call a dentist to come and help us with trying to interpret a sign. We might call somebody who's good with bones, like an anthropologist. So every little discipline that's involved might come together and help you to be able to work out why that individual passed away. Human remains are not always, I mean, it can be a whole body, but it can be parts of the body. And that's where the challenge comes in, to be able to, again, because whether it's a full intact person or remains, you still have to afford it the care, the dignity, and you know, you do a thorough job when you get it. The forensic mortuary technician is, in my opinion, or I think it's general consensus, is that they're the most integral part of what we do.
When I do an autopsy, I always have a technician working with me, and I always, the analogy I make is that I'm a surgeon and they're my scrub nurse. So they're my right-hand person, they are helping me do all sorts of stuff. If I had to work without them, I would be 10 times slower than I am.
Our mortuary technicians are with us, we are a team effort. Many of the times before we start a case, there's like a little sort of collaborative session where we work out the approach to the case, because the mortuary technician does the actual dissection. So if we have agreement about how it should be done at the outset, what specimens to be taken, it goes a long way in getting things done efficiently. Also, the mortuary technician at the end does all the reconstruction, which I think is the crucial bit, because sometimes certain individuals have been injured in polytrauma, there's extensive injuries on the body, and the forensic mortuary technician takes the time and the care in actually reconstructing it. And I think that also is what makes families appreciative about it, because eventually they get their loved one back and they can actually do a viewing when they probably couldn't have done. So again, I can't emphasize the importance of our forensic mortuary technician, absolutely an integral part of our team, and it really helps us get the job done. So, Cassia, this is our typical autopsy suite. This is where you're going to be spending the next couple of weeks with us.
I've always been interested in forensics. I think people would say I watch too many crime shows, like a lot of people. So I just thought it'd be an interesting field to experience more of within medicine, because we don't really get to do a lot with pathology in general, let alone forensic pathology. So I thought it's a unique experience that I could get, especially in my elective term.
It's a constant puzzle, putting things together, using different disciplines to get to the end point. And that's what they do as clinicians. So I would strongly recommend that they come and or either view videos about autopsies, speak to pathologists, come and spend time with us. We offer electives. Just to come and, you know, be a little fly on the wall here and watch what we do. And I guarantee you that it'll be eye-opening, because they'll get to see how different it is. Because I'm sure they, as medical students, have also their preconceptions of things.
It's just like being in a surgery. This is just a person. But something I didn't realize before I came is, I guess, how that whole process works, how you do the actual sort of surgeries, and how you can actually see like real pathology, things that we learn about in med school, things that you see in medicine, you talk about all the time, but you can actually see, like, here is a blocked coronary artery, here is heart disease, here's cancer. You never know what you're gonna see, and you can actually physically see it rather than just learning about it in a textbook.
You do need to know lots of medicine. So if you are interested in all of medicine, so I need to know what ambulance officers do. I need to know what emergency doctors do. I need to know what surgeons do. I don't need to know how to do a Whipple's procedure, but I need to know what a Whipple's procedure looks like when it's been done. Because when I have a patient that dies and comes here with a Whipple's procedure, I need to understand that. So you need to know a lot about different surgeries. You need to know a little bit of toxicology. You need to know a little bit about the legal system. So if you're somebody who's sort of, you know, can't make up your mind and there's lots of things that you're really interested in, it's actually a pretty good job for that, because you will find things that feed you intellectually on your career path.
Often police are at the front line, you know, at the scene, and it's very crucial that they be able to convey what they see to us so that we can interpret the different signs at autopsy. Sometimes police get invited to the autopsy because having them there also helps. And different branches of the police might also be very useful. For example, ballistics.
The pathologists gather medical evidence. So when we are asked to give evidence in court, that's what we present. The medical evidence is to what we found at the autopsy. We can sometimes make certain conclusions from interpreting the medical evidence. So the pathologist can provide an expert opinion, based on the experience and based off the examination.
What you say is very important, and the way you say it is also important. Your role always is to be scientifically sound, present the facts in a very unbiased way, and try and be clear and get your point across so that everybody understands it and that it helps the legal system.
There are definitely certain conditions that we cannot identify at post-mortem that may run in families. So we have a process whereby we notify families on completion of the autopsy report, usually, that there may be a potential genetic condition and that they should seek advice from their general practitioner.
Sometimes somebody will have, you know, maybe a connective tissue disorder that the family didn't know they had, and then their siblings can be monitored to make sure that they don't have a similar adverse outcome.
We may, in certain instances, with permission of the coroner, provide any stored tissue samples that we may have from of the deceased for further testing. For example, I had a case of a aorta dissection where we did make a referral of the family, and it was actually diagnosed that there was it's not a genetic condition.
We've got lots of different spiritual and religious needs, and we really respect that. We have social workers who liaise with the families, and if I can understand what your needs are, I can help give the coroner and the family closure and answers while still working within the parameters of what the family needs.
I would want families to know that we are your advocates. A lot of the time, family members are concerned, will my loved one be well taken care of? Is it just being dismissed? Am I being heard? So my role in this is to give families a hearing, listen to what they have to say, take all their concerns into consideration, and then when I do the autopsy, prepare a report that they're then able to understand.
From that sadness, I can find ways to help the family. I can give answers to maybe treating doctors that were looking after that person who can maybe go on and help another person in the future. I can find genetic conditions in families that might save a life. I can help with organ donation. So when somebody dies and it's really sad, but then you find out that, 10 other people got organs and their life is improved by it. So you can take a tragedy that you can't have any effect on, but help people get something out of it and find the silver lining.
One thing that I think families would love to hear is just how much care and time is devoted to their loved one or family member once they're here. They're not just another body that's come through to us. They were a living person. They are still a person, and we try to still treat them with respect.
I like to go home and I like to create. I like to do artistic things. So that's for me the balance. Is that I go home and it's a bit meditative, I switch off. I also go to the gym, so going to the gym and exercising I find really helps with sort of just getting some of those emotions out and dealing with that. But I think everybody finds the thing that they need to have balance in their life, and balance is really important.
That's why community support among us is very important. We're a small bunch of forensic pathologists, but everyone's together. So, debrief, support each other, talk about it, and then funny enough, forensic pathologists don't stress the small stuff. It's funny, when you work in this job, little things don't matter. You say, it's a little battle, leave it. You look at the bigger picture.
It's so rewarding. I know it's not an easy job, but it is so rewarding to give people closure that this is the last examination this person will ever get. And it's the last chance the family's ever gonna have to get answers. And if I can give that to someone, if I can give them peace of mind and closure, or I can help with that process for them, that's so rewarding.